Montcalm brings European tactics into the wilderness, moving massive siege guns to attack the enemy strongholds head-on. In 1 year, he has two stunning victories. He devastates the British at Fort Oswego. Then he moves south and captures Fort William Henry. In North America, the British are losing forts.
Montcalm mounts an assault on Lake George. This time, 2,000 warriors go with him. In August 1757, 150 Indian canoes accompany an armada of French bateaux gliding down the lake. They are surging by land and water toward Fort William Henry. From the fort, the British realize Montcalm is setting up an encampment near the lakeshore. But they don't yet realize that an advance party, 3,000 strong, has already set up two more camps in the woods, close to the fort's provincial encampment and the fort itself. The British are surrounded. Montcalm needs to get his cannons into firing range. He orders his troops to dig a network of trenches. 500 men work round the clock for 3 days, digging their way toward the fort. By daylight, Munro's forces do what they can to disrupt the French efforts.
Handle cartridge! Charge cartridge! Ram cartridge! Prime! Advance the piece!
Ready!
Munro continues to expect news of reinforcements at any moment. The next day, General Webb finally returns the courier with his reply. Care had been taken to hide Webb's letter, but its discovery gives the French the upper hand. On the morning of August 6th, the siege opens as it had the previous 2 days, with the British bombardment directed at the French advance. But Montcalm's trenches are at last within range of the fort. This time, the French answer back with a burst of cannon and mortar rounds. From exposed positions just outside the fort walls, Indian snipers harass the British gunners.
Fire! Allons-y!
casualties in the fort are mounting. The French artillery proves devastating. At one point, they hit the fort's flag. When a carpenter attempting to repair it is killed, the symbolism is not lost on either side. According to the etiquette of siege warfare, Munro can surrender with honor only after the fort's walls have been breached. With the walls losing timber, the fort's engineer reports to Munro. The structure may not hold for long. Surrender is Munro's only choice.
Is yours. I fear, having let them go, which I must, I will only fight the same men again when I drive towards Albany.
Magua's village and lodges were burnt. Magua's children were killed by the English. I was taken a slave by the Mohawk who fought for the Grey Hair. Magua's wife believed he was dead and became the wife of another. In time, Magua became blood brother to the Mohawk to become free, but always in his heart, he is Huron.